Mr. Minister, my name is Paul Smatza. I had the pleasure of conducting many discussions with you when I was the managing director of the World Economic Forum, and it is really a pleasure to see you again tonight. Let me ask you two interrelated questions. Number one, do you think that there is real trust between the United States and China? And number two, do you think that really the United States is coming to terms with the implications of the emergence of China as a superpower? Thank you, Mr.
I do not think there is a high degree of trust. There is a high degree of diplomatic friendliness and an avoidance of unnecessary conflict. Trust means you believe the other person means what he says, and it's not just diplomaties, but really it comes from his heart. Like the U.S. and Britain.
And the second question related to the U.S. coming to terms.
Well, whether the U.S. comes to terms with eventually big and powerful China, it has to face up to that fact. And when they suggested G2, China opted out very wisely because China preferred G20. So it's modest, it's 1 of 20. If it dissents, well, it's only 1 of 20 dissenting voices. But the U.S. understands it. In 20, 30 years, the GDP of China will be greater than the U.S. The technology will be behind the U.S., but will catch up. Asymmetrical technology will change the power balance. So I would say that when Obama accepted G20 as against G8, it was a recognition that there is a big player emerging in the bloc. It has to be recognized, whether you like it or not. But both sides want to avoid conflict and carry on with economic cooperation in a peaceful way.